Hi, in this video I will tell you about our recent review article focused on pegylation. The first publications on the synthesis of polyethylene glycol date back to 1859 when Portuguese researcher Agostinho Vicente Lourenco reported experiments on heating ethylene glycol and ethylene dibromide mixtures in sealed tubes. An isolation of products ranging from diethylene glycol to hexaethylene glycol. In the same year, Charles Adolf Wurtz reported the study of the reaction between ethylene oxide, ethylene glycol, and acetic acid. He observed the formation of a solid crystalline product soluble in water. In 1929, Staudinger and Schweitzer studied the polymerization of ethylene oxide using a number of catalysts and isolated polyethylene glycols different in molecular weights. In 1930, the manufacture of polyethylene glycol was launched by adding ethylene oxide to ethylene glycol in the presence of bases, according to this scheme. And at present, PEG is synthesized in industry by the anionic ring-opening polymerization of ethylene oxide initiated by the nucleophilic attack of a hydroxide ion on an epoxy ring. And polymers with molecular weight of up to 40 kilodalton are commonly called polyethylene glycols or PEG, and higher molecular weight polymers are called polyethylene oxide or PEO. The dependence of the melting temperature of polyethylene glycol on its molecular weight is shown in this figure. When PEG is oligomeric, it shows an increase in the melting point with the growth of its molecular weight. However, above certain molecular weight, the melting point no longer changes, and this is when PEG is considered to have true polymeric properties. Depending on the molecular weight, ethylene oxide polymers can be colorless liquids, waxy or solid materials. Polyethylene glycol and polyethylene oxide find numerous applications in pharmaceutical and cosmetic products. They are present in some cup syrups, injection formulations, and also solutions that stimulate bowel movements. Pegylation is a covalent or non-covalent attachment of PEG to particles, surfaces, biopolymers, or even small molecules in order to modify their properties. This modification mainly used to improve properties of pharmaceuticals and biomedical surfaces. It offers several advantages, such as more favorable pharmacokinetics, better stability, and enhanced therapeutic activity. Pegylation often imparts stealth properties to the object coated with PEG, which means it makes it less visible in a biological environment. Pegylated lipsomes and nanoparticles are used to increase the time of particle circulation and accumulation in the tumor, to reduce the immunogenicity of adenoviruses, and to increase the time of circulation of viral gene vectors, which makes it possible to use pegylated coatings in new areas of pharmacotherapy. In 1995, the FDA approved the first drug called Doxil based on pegylated liposomes, and Doxil stealth liposomes increased the bioavailability of doxorubicin by 90 times within 1 week after injection, while increasing the circulation time in the blood and the elimination half-life. Pegylation of proteins is a clinically proven approach to increase the elimination half-life and decrease the immunogenicity of protein therapy. This approach helps to increase the molecular weight of proteins, masks their surface, and improves pharmacodynamics and pharmacokinetics. There are currently a number of marketed pegylated proteins approved by Food and Drug Administration. Recently, pegylation of particles was also found to facilitate their permeation through the mucus layer of the mucosal surfaces. This has resulted in a number of research papers developing pegylated mucus-penetrating particles for drug delivery to the eye, the brain, gastrointestinal tract, and reproductive tract. Pegylation of small drug molecules could also sometimes lead to beneficial effects. For example, in our recent study, it was demonstrated that pegylation of haloperidol could prevent its penetration into the brain. which leads to very useful therapeutic effects in some other organs and helps to avoid unwanted side effects. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you would like to learn more about pegylation, I would suggest you to read our review paper. In fact, pegylation recently attracted attention of the general public, which is related to its role in COVID-19 vaccine. Recently developed COVID-19 vaccines also include pegylated lipids in their structure. An article published a few days ago reported about a small number of patients who received Pfizer BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine and developed severe allergic reactions. Some people suspect that PEG may have triggered these reactions. However, more research needs to be done to prove if it is the case. I will leave the links to our review and the article about COVID-19 vaccines in the comments. Thank you.